This video is part of a series that demonstrates the Genesys integrated board flow. Products featured include Genesys Core, WhatIF Frequency Planner, Spectrasys System Architecture Design, M-Filter Microstrip Filter Synthesis Tool, and Momentum GX Planar 3D Electromagnetics. Now we would like to show a Genesys integrated board flow demo by designing a dual band 802.11 Wi-Fi receiver. We're going to use WhatIF to find a spur free IF, use Spectrasys to analyze the system, synthesize an RF filter from within Spectrasys, and then perform a Momentum GX EM analysis on the filter. The 802.11 design is a dual band at 2.4 and 5.4 gigahertz with 10 megahertz and 50 megahertz bandwidths. We'll start out by using WhatIF spur free IF synthesis. The first thing we want to do in our design is determine a spur free IF, and to do this we're going to use the WhatIF frequency planner. I've opened up Genesys to a blank schematic screen, and you can see the workspace tree is on the left, and this is like our project manager. The button on the far left is the new item button. If you click on that and scroll down to synthesis and then add WhatIF frequency planner, I'm going to use the factory default values and the default name. And when I click OK, it opens up the WhatIF screen. And this is the properties screen, and you can see there's three tabs: settings, inputs, and type. In the first settings tab, we're going to select the number of mixers, and I want to select two since it's a dual band design. The IF is going to be at the mixer output as it's a down converter. The spurious order, I'm going to select, we can go up to 10, but I'm, or excuse me, 20, but I'm going to select 10, which is 5x5 spurs. The amplitude range is 100 dB, which means that we're going to look at spurs down to minus 100 below our IF. And then we're going to look at all intermediate frequencies. When I click on the input tab, this is where you enter the parameters for each of your mixers. And you can see the two mixers on the left. I'm going to click on mixer number one, and I select whether I want a summer difference and whether I want a low side or high side LO. I'm going to select low side. And my center frequency for the first mixer is going to be 2450. My RF bandwidth is going to be 100. My IF bandwidth is going to be 10. And my input drive level is going to be 20 with an LO drive level of 10. So then I click on mixer number 2, and it allows me to enter the properties for mixer number 2. I'm going to use the same difference in low side LO, but my RF center frequency is going to be 5350. My RF bandwidth is going to be 300. My IF bandwidth is going to be 50. My input drive level is going to be minus 35, and LO again is 10. And then the next tab is the type tab. This is where you select the mixer types, and the selections are either a double balanced mixer, where if you click on the advanced tab, you can enter in the parameters such as forward voltage and diode balance, or if you can use intermod tables. And we actually have, if you click on this ellipsis button, it will open up our libraries, and we have a number of different manufacturers' libraries that are built in. I'm going to select the Hittite library, and I've pre-selected the HMC218S8. I just double-click on it, and it adds it in. And for mixer number 2, I'm going to do the same, use the same mixer. So after we have everything completed in the inputs, you just click the apply button, and as you can see, I'm going to close the window so that you can, or move the window so you can see it a little bit better, and expand. It brings up a graph that shows the mixers, spurs, and the level. Along the x-axis is the IF frequencies, and along the y-axis the spur output levels relative to IF and DBC. And if you hover over these, you can see this is from mixer number 1. It's a 1x3 spur. The blue ones are from mixer 1. The red spurs shown are from mixer number 2, and it tells you that's a 2x4 spur. And you can even right-click on these and add what we call an info balloon, which will retain the data. And you can see the green lines, if I hover over them, are spur-free areas. So we have a spur-free area at about starting about 672, and then another one about 1517. And, you know, I'd like an maybe an IF a little bit lower in frequency. So what you can do is you can come back, click on any of these tabs, and change parameters to see if maybe we could, you know, come up with some different spur-free areas. So I'm going to click on Mixer 2, and I'm going to check and see if maybe high side will work. So I can switch to high side, click Apply, and immediately you see we have some new spur-free areas. But there's none that are really lower in frequency down here. So I can see that I have a spur here at just at about minus 81, and then there's no other spurs higher than that. So if I go back to my settings tab and change, let's say I can handle spurs down to minus 80. If I put in 80, then you can see that we now have a spur-free area starting from about 212 megahertz to 423 megahertz, and this is in the range that I really wanted to put my IF, and I can live with spurs down to minus 80. That concludes part one of the Genesys Flow video. Please continue to part two of the Genesys Flow video to continue this series.